Thank you. Hello and welcome everybody to the last live stream before we get into multiplayer. Tomorrow there is actually the release date. So I thought just let's do a last live stream before that's gonna happen, and of course a last live stream so I can reach 1000 hours of playing the Hunter in my the Hunter career together with you guys. So yeah, I can show you in the stats actually where that is. On the lifetime time stats, it says right here 998 hours and 6 minutes of play time. So yeah, we probably will reach 1000 hours of playtime today. Yeah, and that's quite intense. Of course there's players who have a lot more than 1000 hours, but I do actually not have that much time to play. Only when I actually record for my Let's Play series most of the time. So yeah, I'm quite happy about that. So and of course my apologies, there has not been much going on my channel lately. I did not have so much time, but of course since multiplayer is just one day away, we will pick up some pace when multiplayer comes out actually. I can see there's already 19 people on the stream here live, and yeah, what's gonna happen today? We will have the 1000 subscribers special raffle. Interesting enough, it's already, I can show you, this actually shows you how long it's been that I haven't done a video. Well, we are already almost at 1500 subscribers. So yeah, I've been a little bit short on time for doing videos, but nevertheless we will decide the raffle today. And actually I have, you know, I have cut it out all your comments. I printed it out and cut it out. And later I will just, whenever we decide to do that, I will just, you know, grab in there and decide a winner live. So yeah, let's switch back to the Hunter page and let me see what you guys are writing here. Yes, I will read the chat. I have a second screen here next to me, so I can read the chat. So yeah, I will be you know, I can't read all of it when I'm playing, but yeah, what's the plan for today? So we could actually we decided already last time that we will hunt in Hirschfelden today. And now let's just check out together what kind of missions, competitions we could do in this one. So someone told me already before the stream started that there is a wild boar competition actually going on right now. So let's check this out. Oh yeah, that's the top boar intermediate. And yeah, Red Stag also, someone mentions it here. That's Red Deer in English. So, but, you know, let's just activate that one. It says here it has started already. So we can actually just activate it. And let's look into it. What is the specs for it? Yeah, species wild boar, of course, on Hirschfelden. Any weapons permitted, that is always good. Highest score, yeah, that's the kind of competitions that I like most. And yeah, let's see, what do we have to beat? 1117.624. Okay, that's gonna be tough. That's gonna be tough, yes. So, well, we will try. Now let's see the red deer. There's also the top stack starter. So starter means I do not have that many harvests. Max 50 red deer harvests. So it seems that I have hunted less than 50 red deer, which is quite embarrassing actually, but that's how it is. So let's activate that as well. And it should be quite much the same specs as for the wild boar challenge. Yeah, any weapon permitted, highest score, that's nice. So, and there we have to beat 274.450. My best was around the position 4 here in this competition, so that's gonna be tough. And yeah, I think let's not waste any time now. I will just start the hunt, and I think to start with we take it from, yeah, let's take it from the Rittersteinhütte. And yeah, let's just go ahead. We start at 6 o'clock in the morning. That's like my favorite time, hunting in the mornings. So let's do it. And I need to switch it on the game as soon as it's loaded. In the meantime, I just look at the chat. So we have 20 people in the stream now. And yeah, okay. Teox18 is asking for a shout out. Hi, Teox. Lucas is watching from Canada, if I got it right. And there's someone called Pratsy Fan. So thanks for that. Cold Blood Croc is also here again. I saw him in my last previous live streams. And actually, we could switch now to the game. So, yeah, here we go. Let me just put that away. I think that's fine. All right. So, let's just enter the reserve. As for the weapons, I think since we do only need to take care about taking weapons that are actually permitted to hunt wild boar and red deer, I think I'm just gonna leave it to the 8x57 IS Unschütz, which is kind of, yeah, it's kind of my favorite weapon in the game. And of course the Parker Python. I think that you know, if you have the Parker Python, there's no need to switch back to the Snakebite anymore. We know the Snakebite is a bit stronger than the Parker, but I like the sights of the Parker so much more. It's my favorite bow. Of course the crossbow is also one of my favorites, and yeah, we take with the ground blind, and of course the collars, and we have, yeah, 12 red tracer flare arrows should be enough, I guess, and 20 rounds for the Unschütz. Yeah, I think I will just decide that, because in the chat, of course, most people have some different ideas. Yeah, Teox18 is just mentioning that the 857 was actually part of the retail box, of the German version of the German retail box. I think that was part of a deal between Unschütz and the Hunter. But I think right now. Oh yes, Anonymi just reminded me. I have only three sprays left, so I'm gonna take a fresh one with me. That's much better. Yeah, I think that by now the 857 should be available in the store. It was exclusive for I think 6 months after the box was released, so you could only have it when you bought the retail box, but I think now it's available in Doc's Outfitters shop. And yeah, so let's just continue into the game. My SpongeBob SquarePants mug just realized. Yeah, we are here at Rittersteinhütte, as you can see on the map. And just to say it straight away, down here, this area here in the south is very good for hunting red stag. Here where this exclamation mark sign is, I know that there is also a very good spot for red deer. It's actually the place where this awesome, what is that? It's a farmer's house or something. That's up here. So that's also good for red stag, but I think we should first try and try to find something down here. And yeah, I think of course let's reload our weapons. And guys, please tell me in the chat if the quality of the video is good enough, if you see it fine, if you can hear me good, if you can hear the game sound and everything. The bow, of course, we do not have to reload that one. And of course, always the scent eliminator. I personally use it all the time. Actually, I make sure I have it on myself pretty much all the time that I'm hunting. But of course, for some of you guys that might sound a little bit wasteful, but yeah, that's just how I use the scent eliminator. Wild boar's lure, I think I have it. Yeah, I have the, can actually equip it. And also we have the hawk scent spray and even the roe deer scent spray, so we should be fine for that. So that's it. So yeah, let's actually head somewhere around here, because I know that in this area particularly I have a lot of success with red deer, and I hope this spot won't let me down today. As for the wild boar, we might have to actually retire to a different lodge or just fast travel to my other tent that I have on the Hirschfelden, because this area is not particularly good for hunting wild boars. So yes, again, sorry that it took so long until I made this live stream happen, actually, because as said already, the shuffle that we are doing live today is actually based on the 1,000 subscribers special shuffle where I give away a Pathfinder membership and 1,000 EMS. So by now we almost reached 1,400 subscribers, and of course that is a bit, you know, a bit late to do that, but I hope you guys are okay with that still. And of course, multiplayer is right next door. Tomorrow it's gonna happen. They will update the service, and I can't tell you how much I'm looking forward to this. I have no idea how we are going to do this together with you guys, my viewers, because I can imagine that quite some of you would just like to, you know, go hunting with me, but of course I cannot, you know, I cannot tell everyone that it's gonna happen. But of course we will do some, we will do make some something happen where I give you the chances. Oh, red deer, there's a red stag, it's a male. So let's try to get that one. He was somewhere, like, I think it was somewhere here, roughly. And let's hope it's a big one. Oh, this chat window is always confusing me. Spoons a Cola asks me on the chat for what reason I do like the 857. Well, I think there is many reasons to like this one. First of all, I really do like the look of it. He's answering straight away. So I think I should kind of set up an ambush here somewhere. Whoa! He's really communicating with me. So let's see. I would like to, because, you know, from the place I am right now, I can actually see a lot. Just the wind is not really good. So I think for this one, I will not do a bow shot. That might be a little bit too risky. And I hope to spot him very soon. There he is. Oh, there he is. Can you see him? I'm sorry, it's quite foggy. But yeah, this one looks actually quite okay to me. He's not gonna be a top scorer. So let's just let's not waste a lot of time here, and let's try to get him. Wind is better now. There he is. Whoa. He is very vocal. Oh, what distance was that now? 29, that's actually okay for the bow. Let's do this. All right. That's a clear hit. Just don't know how good that was. What do you guys think? he was taking off quite fast, so yeah, we got him at least. That's for sure. Long shot, I hope it is. Yeah, it was a little bit high, I think, so I think it could be a body shot. What was my most exciting hunt? Lucas is asking. Whoa, that's a tough question. Oh, that's a body shot. Yeah, that's a body shot. So let's just wait here a little bit and let him, you know, let him settle down, hopefully bedding down. Because one of the biggest mistakes that you can do after, you know, after getting a body shot on an animal, especially with a bow, and especially with the Parker from, you know, from a distance longer than 20 meters, if you straight away go after that animal, you will, you know, you will only push it further and further, especially when you're running or walking upright. That's not gonna do any good to find that animal, so we just let it settle down a little bit. LP John Mayers asks how what's my name? Oh no, he asked someone else, because that would be a little bit weird if he didn't know my name on the Hunter. My name is Pratze. So let's just settle, let him settle down before we track him. And in the meantime, I was just going to say something, but I forgot actually. What was I talking about before I took the shot? What was that again? Please guys, as long as you are able to, keep it in English in the chat, because this is an English live stream. If you cannot write in English, it's okay to write in German, of course, but please don't have conversations going in German in the chat, because this is an English live stream. And oh yeah, we could do the shuffle actually. Cold Blood Rock, no, Croc. Just yeah, let's do it. What should we do first? Let's raffle first for the 1000 EMS or first the Pathfinder? I think the 1000 EMS should be first, right? So here is all the comments, and let's do it. I have one, and it is DH055 Raptor, and it's perfect because it says I would like the 1000 EMS so I can get some stands and establish a bite barrel stocked fully. Thanks. That's what he commented. This guy, Raptor. So he actually wanted a 1000 EMS, so it's perfect. I will put this down here so I can send him the code later. And I don't know if he's watching or something, but if not, this stream of course will also be uploaded on YouTube afterwards. So congratulations, Raptor, and yeah, I will email you on YouTube about that. So that is the first one, and let's just continue to track that red deer. So that will give us our first entrance into that competition. And Raptor, just people in the chat are giving you congratulations. So so let's track him now there. We could have some guessing on what he's going, what that bull is going to score. What do you guys think? Oh, we get a call from a female roe deer. I think we will just let that pass. Okay, Ononemi says 160 score. Lucas says 150 score. Teox18 says 210. Cold Blood Croc 192. The Hunter GER 251. Teox, he's going on 184.547 now. Slimnor, I hope I'm saying that right. 155 spoons. Okay, I'm not gonna read everything now, but we will see in a second, hopefully, what the score is. But it seems to be that you guys think it's around, you know, in the 100s, mid to high. Oh, I can actually see a red deer. Oh, guys, that is another one. Whoa, that one looks big. There's a whole group of them. That seems to be the big bull with all the females following him. Look at this. One, two, three, four females, and the stack seems to be right behind that. Oh well. Let's just call him and hope he's going to walk over that hill top. Case 5150 says hello. Hi there. We have actually 29 viewers now. That's amazing. Yes, Lucas says, do not get trolled by females again. I really try to not get trolled now, 'cause that usually happens a lot. So let's first take care about this one. And typically only the females are answering. So that's why I always keep saying, if you hear a call of a female red deer, it's always worth to check it out. You know, you never know. Sometimes there is a whole group, and the monster red stag leading away. Whoa. It's always hard to stay calm when you l lose sight of the animal, but we all know that being patient is key here. And for red deer, you need to call them a little bit more frequently than other deer species. Oh, there he is. That is actually the one we shot. But I'm quite sure I saw another one. What do you guys think? That is the one we shot, so we actually have to, you know, we have to take him out first. How we should, you know, we should kill him. We should take him out of its misery. Yeah, let's just use the rifle for that. Okay, mission accomplished. And I think actually there was not a different male. Or that one. There is one actually. Maybe I should have used the bow then, in that case. But I know where I saw him last, so we can track him down later, I hope. I just marked it on the Hunter Mate. And now let's see what kind of score we got. No, oh no, Naomi, no headshots. I do not like headshots. But with a rifle that of that caliber, of course, it is well possible. Oh, hard shot. Oh, sorry, I misread. I misread that completely. But it seems from the blood, I don't know. Let's just check it out. Yes, it is. Congrats, Onanemi. That was a very good one. Now, can someone just see what? Oh, Glenn 5555 said 159, and Onanemi said 160, so that was very close. Wow. That's good. So let's see what kind of result we get. Which gives you position 65 in top stack starter. All right. Let's take a nice picture of him. Something like that. As you can see, the arrow, the placement was right into the shoulder blade, so way too high. And the bullet actually was perfect on the heart. So that's the first success already. And yeah, let's try to find that other stag that we saw. So we are really on the red deer fever here. Another thing that is very helpful when hunting red deer is to now and then, like every 10 minutes or so, give it a call, because red stag do actually respond to calling directly. Other species do not do that, like the mule deer and the white-tailed deer, black-tail. Oh, sorry, what am I doing here? I wanted to use that one. So let's see if he is still in the area. If not, we will have to follow him a little bit longer. Yes, elk also do respond directly. That's correct. I think that could be him, but my skill level for red deer is not that high, so I can't really tell. But I think that was the direction that I watched when I saw this one stag fleeing. And I'm still not 100% sure if that was a male, but it actually looked like it was. And I know for sure that this area here is very good for hunting red stag. So we will just go a little bit further and then try to call again. And if we get lucky, he will respond. But I think it was... Oh, there he is! There he actually is! Look at this one! And he's nervous, so I think we gotta shoot him. I will take the shot. Because I'm not gonna risk. Alright. Whoa. Oh, you guys think he's in the 200s scoring? That would be nice, of course. I myself think that he is actually 190 or very low 200s, something like that. But I'm not sure. As for the shot, I'm also not so sure. But I should be somewhere in the engine room. Lungs, hopefully. Yeah, the 9.3 is 9.3 is very good for stopping power. That's correct. That's something else. I think blood should be up there. So yes, well, multiplayer tomorrow. That's, you know, that's just amazing. What do you guys think of that? Oh, lung heart, that's good. So that was a good shot, at least. Yeah, that's a good idea. Cold block, blood croc says we could do the second round of shovel after we back this one. Yeah. The Great Dragon says multiplayer is going to be awesome, and I agree. I hope it's gonna, you know, it's gonna be a whole different world. So many possibilities. And there he is already. Look at him. Didn't go far. Now, do you want to adjust your score hints? I don't know. I think he could scratch the 200 mark, something like that. Well, it is a nice looking one, that's for sure. He has a lot of crown points. He is one untypical that will oh well, I don't know how it's with the red stack, if that is considered an untypical point. I guess not. And it's on both sides as well, quite symmetrical actually, I would say. So it could be a little bit higher. Here we go, 203. So yeah, that was my guess, something around 200. Shoulder blade, right lung. Yeah, that's actually 204. Yeah, that's correct. So nice, let's see what kind of result we get for this one. Which gives you position 38 in top stack starter. That's good. Top 50. And of course the day is not over yet. So who was closest with his guess? I can't remember. Oh, Pratzefan, he said 204. That was perfect. Nice. So, let's see, where could we go next? We could actually check out, yeah, we should go a little bit more into the south, maybe like, you know, could also check out the stand, but yeah, let's go here. Let's go across this big field, and because there usually is a lot of red stack action going on, and that could be promising. And of course, I'm not expecting to find a competition winner, but you never know. I mean, a 200 plus scoring one is actually already quite nice. Oh yeah, we forgot the shuffle. Let's do that now. Thanks for reminding me. Shuffle it. Oops. Almost fell off. Okay, guys. This is for the Pathfinder membership now. And I have one. And it is Chipper Syme. He says, he wrote in the comment, "Congratulations, Pratse, great job with your videos, and they have gave me a lot of inspiration when I hunt and hunter. I really like to win the EMS, sorry, because I need more equipment to really get the hunter career where I want it. Thanks for reading this, and good luck with your future hunts. Best regards." So, well, this guy actually wanted the EMS, right? So, let me just do something spontaneous. He's gonna get 1,000 EMS and the park also, and we do another one for the Pathfinder membership. And if that's going to be another one that actually wants the 1,000, then he just only gets the membership. Can I even do that? Or, I don't know, will the guy probably complain? Is he here actually? Ah, he's gonna be fine. If not, he will get a Pathfinder membership as well, but I don't think so. He's clearly writing he wants the EMS. Oh, we got a female calling. Oh, she's actually right there. Let me show you guys. Okay, so let's do it for the Pathfinder membership right now. I got one. Let me see. I made 17. Hi Pratze, nice episode. I'm watching your videos since the beginning. I don't really need Pathfinder since I bought Trail Runner a year ago, but I would like to buy a tent for Logger's Point. Well, now you just got a Pathfinder, and yeah, that's what you get. And the other two will get 1,000 EMS. So that was the raffle part. We got actually three winners now. And Sand Eliminator wore off. We're gonna fix that quickly. right. So congratulations to all the winners. And now let's concentrate on the hunting again. Wind seems to be perfect, blowing in our face. And again, the female calling. That was a funny comment. And I think after we checked out the fields here, we can still, you know, we can use the camping supplies. But is there actually a camping site here on the map? I don't think so. No. Okay, then we will just restart from the tent here, probably. And then we could go in this area here to find some wild boars. I think that should work out actually. I think the tracks that we pick up here is mostly from the females that we spooked. So I'm quite sure if I use the caller now we might get some female answering. So yeah, multiplayer, I didn't think that it's going to happen so fast actually. Alright, there we go. Female calling. And but as we could read in the status update, they will release it and they already said that there still is bugs in the version they will release. So I'm not too sure what you think of that, but I guess most people are just excited about it to be released. I just hope the bugs that might still be in there are not, you know, are not game breakers or something. But then again, I cannot imagine that the developers would do that. Here we go, females. I think they are just reacting on that call that I made. So we just leave them. So you guys are discussing about a African-inspired reserve. Well, I heard that or read about that a lot in the forums. There's always people asking for that. But I think that would be a huge task for the developers, because you know, you cannot take parts from the current game and modify it to the area fitting, because Africa would be so different to the American or European reserves that we got. Okay. Spoons of Cola says Australian reserve would be nice for him to shoot pigs, camels, and kangaroos. Okay. Oh, Elements Hunter, hi there. Welcome to the stream. It just says a friend told him that I was streaming. That's nice. And I think I should concentrate a little bit more on the game. I'm always looking to the chat. So for all the people joined in new, we have done the raffle already, we got winners already, and we signed up for two competitions. One is wild boar, top boar, I think intermediate it was, and then also top stag starter, and we are currently on position 38, I think, with a stack that we shot with a score of 204. Andy Hood says, happy hunting, Pratze. Thank you. And now it seems to be pretty quiet around here. So let's try the caller one more time. Yeah, the female behind us. So maybe it was not that good to call now, because that group of females might follow us now. Troll females, well. It just is the case that there is more female animals on the reserve than male animals. So of course it's more likely to run into female animals. Oh, there's a track of a red deer, but I do not know if it's male or female, since my tracking level is not high enough to detect that. That actually already shows that I was not playing that much lately, but it'll change, believe me. We're getting close, so let's just check out that one. I kind of have the female it could be, the feeling it could be a male, but I don't know at all. And that was behind us again. Luca 56, hello. Someone asks if I can shoot at the mouse. No. I do not like to shoot that mouse because it only kills my stats. Not that my statistics are very good, but still I do not like to shoot at something that will, you know, hurt my statistics. I'm also playing the game very slow paced, as you can see. That is just my style. I know there is ways to hunt that are much more efficient, but that is just for me not hunting. That is only you know, taking advantage of what you know about the game, how it works, but that doesn't feel like hunting at all. So I stick to my technique, which might not be, you know, too much successful, but it gives me the feeling of being there and actually going out there and hunting. I do not hunt in real life. When I grew up, I had a neighbor who is a hunter, and he would sometimes take me with him when he went out hunting. So, but apart from that, I do not have any hunting experiences. You could say I spent my childhood mostly in the forest area. I actually spend a lot of time in the forests. You know, like kids do. There's a roe deer female. That's actually not what we are looking for. The Great Dragon says my English improved. Oh, thanks. That's nice of you to say that. Coldblood Rock, Croc, I keep saying rock, asks if I prefer to hunt wild boars or feral hawks, and to be honest, I prefer the wild boar, because where I live, you can find them, and I've seen them in the wild a couple of times. So it's kind of intense to hunt the wild boar. Well, Robux, Lucas asks why Robux are so rare on Hirschfelden. The thing is, I do not actually think that they are too rare, but the big difference to Hjemmeldal is that on Hirschfelden the time of the year is autumn, whilst on Hjemmeldal it's already almost winter. And roe deer, they group up in the winter time, so that is why you find a lot more animals together on Heimdall, and there is a higher chance to actually get a buck as well in that group. Even groups of only bucks are possible in Heimdall. I saw that once. A group of three or four rodeo bucks. And also the bucks on Heimdall are bigger most of the times. I mean, the chance of seeing a high-scoring roe deer is better on Heimdall, because it's known that Scandinavian roe deer is larger, like from the horns. Oh yes, I do remember that blonde female bear, yeah, that charged at me. That's always very intense. Animals charging at you. And yes, foxes should be coming soon too, that's correct. In yeah, I think two or three status updates back, they mentioned that they are working on the fox, and that it should be released from, yeah, like within 2 months or something from when they mentioned that. And basically they asked the community to help them with that fox. They provided us with early 3D model pictures of the fox on that status update, and they just asked if they got it right, or if there is something we could help them with as for the proportions and stuff like that. Oh yeah, rare animal species. I actually, in my whole career, only shot one female black tail albino and one male wild boar albino. That's like all the rares that I got in, yeah, roughly 4 years of playing. So it is really rare to shoot an animal like that. Someone asks if I would like caribou. Actually, yes. I mean, that's a quite interesting animal. I would not mind having it on Heimdall. Got another call. Yeah, again behind us. So, seems that the female group still is following us. But that was, of course, because I did call a few times. And now it starts raining. Yeah, it looks very empty around here. So we could actually start over at my tent, if you guys want to. We could just, you know, end this hunt here and start over from either here or the other lodge. No, my SpongeBob mug is there's coffee inside it, not vodka or something. So well, yeah, let's do that. Let's start over. Let's leave the reserve. And let's check out here. We could once more check out the competition. So it doesn't say in what position we are, does it? We would have to check here. There we are, 40 already. Dang. We are not the only people hunting. So let's see, let's start from the tent. And let's see, you know, somewhere here we should actually find some wild boars. Yeah, let's start at 7 maybe. Would be okay, I guess. Someone wants to see the cup again. There you go. Yes, Andy Hood is just posting here the release date that the developers have mentioned, and it's definitely tomorrow. So tomorrow we will get multiplayer. So here we are at my tent. Let's see, first of all, Scent Eliminator. Oh, here we get a call straight away, and it's a male. It's a male. Oh, let me see, we have to equip that one. So we should make it like this. And I guess we could just set up the ground blind as well. We have to do that fast in order to not spook it. And maybe here. So let's hope that wasn't too late to call it in. Just hang on. If it's a, you know, a male should just start rushing in after getting that caller. That should be doing it. I just hope he didn't spook or run or like go out of the render distance in the time that we set up the tent. I probably should load my rifle as well. I know we are actually after wild boar and red stag, but of course I will never let pass the opportunity to get a shot on a roebuck. I can hear something. There he is. Okay, we got him. Let's see if he's going down. It's again a little bit high, but he's going down, looking good. Yes! And he's looking decent, actually. And yeah, actually, I just realized I'm shooting the bow on Hirschfelden. In Germany, actually, there's no bow hunting allowed. Oh, guys, I hear a pig screaming. It's a female, but still, it could be a whole group of them. Oh, well, guys, it's starting out good. Let's bring out some scent. Now let's call him as well. Because I recently learned that the caller reaches out longer than a scent, like further. So a scent is actually, yeah, it kind of is the same thing as a call in the way it works. It's luring in the animal to that particular part or spot where you used it, but it's not reaching out that long. Let's just get that buck. No, I don't think that that roebuck is a spiker. but sometimes it, from the, you know, from the front, it looks a bit like it. I first thought that too. Let's hurry up a little bit. And there he is. Shoulder blade. 129.482. That's quite okay. Whoa, that's a bit shaking. Okay. Actually do not have time for a perfect trophy shot, so let's just do it like so. That's good enough. Now let's hope the wild boars will arrive here. Yeah, the boar called by the tower, that's correct. So it might take a little while. Here we go again. Calls again. Yeah, it's on her way. Female boar. Female boar sounds weird. Female wild boar. Just wait, and let's hope she's not alone. That, by the way, is only a stone. I think we put the scent somewhere here. So I could actually give it, just in case, another Okay. Let's see. Now it's down to patience. Czechmes, I think, I don't know if it's right. He says, I hope with multiplayer there will be the possibility to set more markers than one. And perhaps in different colors. So are you talking about the markers you can set on the map? Like there? Yeah, so yeah, if that will, that would be a good thing, of course. Oh, there. There's the boar. Well, the sow and another one. So it's not only one, which is good, but it's two females. Actually have to, if I might decide to use the bow, almost forget that. Whoa. So do you guys think there will be a male one as well amongst them? No idea. Oh yeah, there is another one coming. That looks... There another one. What's that? That's a female as well, so I guess. The last one is a male. Oh, that's really tricky now. No, that's also a female. Is that now a female group? Whoa, whoa, whoa. She's getting too close. Let's see, 150 kilos. Oh, there is... Is it another female? 130. Oh, no. Yeah. That was nothing. I waited too long because I thought that there should be a male as well. Well, let's try to track them then. Well, yes, fail. I mean, it was all females, so there was not really a... I mean, there was not really a point in waiting so long. I mean, there was a point, because I all the time waited for the male, but... It's very easy that it was a group of only females, so if that was the case, then we just screwed up. Yeah, I think we just try to track them down, and if there was a male within this group, we might get a second chance. Let's see if we can make them out from here. Yes, my plan was actually to take the fattest one, like the heaviest one, just to get the best score for the competition. But I took too long to figure out, which resulted in fleeing wild boars. So I think we have to wait until they calm down again, and then we might even be able to call them back in. I can see one, I think. Yeah, there is one. Trotting. Oh, now it's standing. Let's just try a call. Maybe it's reacting. At least we know that there is wild boars in the area, which is always a good thing. Although I have to say, on wild boars or pigs in general, I find them the most random, you know, when it comes to reacting on calls and scents and stuff like that. They tend to trot around a lot, and in that stage they do not really react on calls and scents, so it's a bit tricky. Lucas is asking about the turkey caller. Yeah, that one is a little bit tricky. When you use the turkey caller, you have to find the right rhythm in, you know, when to press the left mouse button, because if you do it too early, it will cut it. Okay, bye bye, Elements Hunter. Thanks for tuning in. It was cool to have you. See you next time, maybe. Did someone, let me check, how long are we actually hunting now? 1.5 hours, something like that. So, we should be very close to the 1,000 hours mark. For those of you who do not know it, I will soon reach 1,000 hours of gameplay time on my account. There's a mushroom. Thanks for that. Oops. Oh, there's the boar. It's one of the females, I guess. Yeah. I think that even was the fattest one. If I'm right. 150 as the top possibility. So what do you guys think? Should we just take her? Because the others, I think that group is quite much spread out now since we spooked them. Oh yeah, Schmonzo asks how he can become friends on the hunter side. Oh, let's just take that one. It's already trotting again. Oh, there's another one. Let's check it out first. That looks to be a boar, isn't it? No. No, that's a female. So I think we are on the same group that we just spooked. And I will take that fat one here. That heavy one. Yeah. Let's do that. Maybe we can try a follow-up shot on the other one. It's quite hard to do when quartering, but we just try. And the other one seems to be gone there. Yeah, let's let her go. I don't know if the second shot was a hit, but we will see about that. And yes, I was just Schmonzer asked how he can be friends with me on my profile. That's quite easy. You just search for friends on the profile and you type in Pratze. And then you can send me a friend request. And then I just accept that and you are my friend. And yes, shooting has nothing to do with the score. Someone was asking if it affects the score if you know, the kind of shooting you do. And the answer to that would actually be a shot in the lungs doesn't make the, you know, doesn't make the score, like the animal, bigger. Also, pheasants, if you shoot them in the air, you do not get a better score for it. But for pheasants, if you get airborne shots, they will appear in leaderboards. If not, then if ground shots do not appear in leaderboards. I think we only hit the first one. Yes. And it was right lung and stomach. Score 173.746. So let's see what kind of result. 91. We are at 91. Yeah, that's not a big one. We got a pheasant call, but since I do not have a shotgun with me, only the bow, which would be ethical, I think we are not really hunting pheasants. Let's see on the map. We could actually... Oh, where should we go? I mean, could, you know, check out the area here, or we could go to this area. Don't know. think we just go into the field here and find a way to cross over. I think we do not need the. But there's that other. Let's shoot her as well. What the heck? Ah, she's going down. Yeah, looks good. So, oh, there she is. She dead? Think so. Cause for hawks, feral hawks and wild boars, if they bed it down after a shot and you get too close, they will get up again. And if you're unlucky, they will even charge you then. They will charge at you. The deer species do not do that. But with wild boars, you should be... Yeah, should be a bit careful. That's why I walk up on it slowly now. But that looks pretty... Yeah, that's dead. Yeah, looking good. So I hope it was a lung shot. Oh, it says intestines. Well, it went down pretty fast, so I think that was okay. 198.965. So we improved actually, even though the guess on the spotting, on the guess this one was smaller. Position 91. Still very small sized one. Looks like we have really tiny wild boars. The cool thing about Hirschfelden is, you know, you can go from field to field and you have, you know, you can see a long distance, and each field will possibly have some surprises for you. So hang on a second, I will have a short break, like 2 minutes, and I'll be back. Okay, here we go. I'm back. So let's see. Let's just continue to that, you know, towards the river. And hopefully we come across some, some more wild boars. Would be nice to get at least one male. That would be good. And we should later also check if we reach the 1000 hours. I mean, so you guys who have this game for a long time, let's say 3 to 4 years, how many hours of playtime do you have? I would expect to most people who have it that long might actually have more playtime than I do. Well, maybe also not, because in the beginning I was playing it like, you know, every day. But especially now in like the last month when it was going towards the multiplayer, since that was announced, I really waited and kind of didn't feel to play the single player, you know, just waiting. I always have that when a new reserve comes up. Oh, we have to equip that. When a new reserve is announced or a new animal, I always find myself waiting for that until I start playing again. So okay, so the Great Dragon played it for 301 hours. That's also something. But you know, in this game you always have, when you are hunting, you have periods where just, you know, nothing is going on really, like now. And of course for a let's play or for streaming, this might be a little boring sometimes, but I do not mind it, because if there wasn't these parts in between your, you know, in between shooting, it would actually not feel like hunting to me. So, even though in my Let's Play series I cut out these rather boring walking parts, I would still not want to miss them. And of course, speaking of that, oh, there was something fleeing actually. I didn't see that. We might have spooked something without realizing. Yeah, I mean, just comes to my mind when actually multiplayer is out tomorrow. Of course, these times when you are searching and for animals, this could be really less boring then, because you are like hunting with your mates. You might be talking on Skype or something, and yeah, I mean, that's just like traveling, walking, and having a good conversation, and that, you know, that's probably going to be really awesome. Gutso62 has 1,267 hours of playing. Oh, that's amazing. And oh, hi, the Martin 55415. Hi there. Someone just was shouting to me in the chat. So, oh, we quite much should actually go towards the river, because across the river there is the sweet corn fields. Oh, there's a boar. Please let it be a male. No, it's a female again. But you know, since wild boars are kind of, yeah, in Europe, it's really hard to get control over them. So I pretty much like to take any opportunity that I get on them. And I think I'm just gonna do that now. Let's see, seems to be on her own so far. I just take it. That's like my style for hunting wild boar. Yes, clean shot. That's how I like it. The Grey Dragon says he would like to play multiplayer with me. Well, I have got lots of messages lately from people telling me they would like to hunt together with me. And I, of course, would also like to hunt with all you guys. But we have to see how we can organize that, because I probably will not be able to hunt with every single one of you who's asking me. So, wow, there she is. Now that's a better score, 357.841. That's a better score for a female at least. And it will give us position 86 in top boar. So yeah, we will just have to see. I definitely will play with you guys in multiplayer. I mean, I will play with my viewers, that's for sure. We just have to see how we organize that or how we do that. Because I recently got a lot of emails from people and telling me they would like to hunt with me, but I cannot promise straight away that I will be able to with everyone, of course. Yeah, someone says, Cold Blood Croc says, what about contests and the winner gets to play with me? Well, we will just see how that. I mean, I will have to come up with something. I do not want to sound like, you know, everyone is wants to hunt with me, but at the same time, I do also not want to have it completely random. Like, that would be a bit unfair, maybe, for some. So I'm sure we will come up with a good way to do that. First, we have to see, of course, how multiplayer is like and what possibilities we have with it before we can actually make some planning. Yeah, of course, I will hunt with the people I like, but if I do not have time to hunt with you, that doesn't mean that I don't like you. So it's not so easy, that topic. But as I said, we find a way to do that. Can we actually cross here? Let's see. I think it should be a. That should be a place where it is possible to cross. And there might also be red deer in this area. Maybe not that many, but. It's always possible. Onimi says coffee must be cold by now. Yes, it is, but I like cold coffee. I don't mind cold coffee. Oh, there was a roadie barking. And someone asked, what's my favorite animal to hunt? Whoa. That's a tough question. I cannot answer that, I think. Sometimes I really feel like hog hunting, sometimes I really feel like hunting whitetail. I mean, I think finding a really big scoring whitetail is one of the most thrilling moments that you can get in this game, for me. Dan858 asks for bear tips. Well, it depends if you want to hunt using the barrel or stalking. For stalking, I can say that on the black bear in Red Feather Falls, you should go north. In the northern parts, you will most likely find them. And of course, you should always walk crouched like I do now, like not so, not upright, but crouching. Oh, there is something. There's a wild boar, female again. Oh, raptor. Could just ride him quickly. He actually won 1000 EMS. Oh, there is that female, okay. This time I would actually like to... Seems she's on her own again. But let's try to get her with the bow. I will try to get on that on that little hill. So we set up a little ambush for that one. Just hope that's gonna work out. She's not really reacting so far. 44. At least we have a good view now and can see if there is some more. There is one. It's another female. It's... That's like... Oh. She actually moved, but where? There. Looks like, oh. Well, might still be, oh, that was wrong. And there is a roe deer calling. Female, okay. That's not so interesting. The wind is actually really bad for me, and she just keeps trotting. That's what I mean with the hawks and the boars. I don't really. It seems like they are just a little more random. Okay, bye, Pratzefan. Have a good day. He just says goodbye. So let's see if we actually can make her turn around. I'm curious now. if that is possible. And that other one seems to be also gone. Here is that female roe deer. And there is another feral hog. Wild boar. And I couldn't make out if it's a male or a female. But let me use the scent now. So as you can see, it sometimes is really worth just, you know, just not shooting on first sight. That's something I really learned with this game. That it's very often a smart thing to not right away start shooting at anything you see moving. Because that way you miss a lot of good opportunities. And of course sometimes, like when we first saw first called in that group of female wild boars, we waited too long. That also can happen. Well, Martin, you've been in the chat, right? So there's no need to write to me in game. I really hope that when multiplayer comes out, this is gone, because I really hate this thing popping up all the time. And that seems to be also female and also not reacting on my scent. That's what I mean. It's just random, kind of. But I like it, because I can imagine in real life they are not very predictable as well, so that is a good thing. Could still wait a little bit longer. What's here? Nothing. Rundogrun1189 says thanks for all the videos, and he can't wait to play the game himself when he gets his new laptop. Oh, there we go, we get a call now. Getting a call is always good, because it means that the animal is actually reacting. Now I missed it, if it was a male or a female. That was stupid. But I think we will find out about that one. Should be somewhere on this field. Probably the female that we saw from here. The other two females seem to have... Oh, there is... The one is coming back, okay. Interesting. 53 meters away, so if I would set up the ground blind now, I would spook it. So I will not do that, of course. And that is indeed the other female. Looks like bad luck. Only female. Wild boars. I think... Oh, there she goes. 29. If she's giving me a better broadside, I will use the bow. And it starts raining. think I'm gonna take her. Okay, it should be a solid hit. Can try to make a follow-up. Oops, that was too early. Here we go. The Great Dragon has to go. White Man's Heil, see you around. Thanks for joining in. So that first shot was an intestine shot, so it was not ideal. Oh, I almost missed that. Anonemi said that in the chat that she doesn't think that I am the average example of a German person. That's a very nice compliment. Not that I dislike German people, but you know, some things that we Germans stand for are really not how I am or how I want to be. And some things, of course, I do well. And Rock'em Sock'em asks if I'm just as excited as him about multiplayer. Of course, I'm so excited about that. Whoa, the second shot was a lung shot. Nice. Yeah, you can see it. It was off. It was too much. Towards the back. Should have calculated the angle better. Whoa. That's like a engine room wipeout. First shot was liver. No, it was the stomach. So the shot registered below is always the first one. So that was a stomach from 12.2 meters. And the second was liver, right lung, and heart. It was a good follow-up shot then. Kind of like to set up the boars, or like the pigs, like this kind of. But it doesn't work out always, so. That looks odd with the foot there, but I don't care. When I examined the droppings, if it said how old it was, I can't remember actually. Sorry about that. I don't know if my tracking skill is high enough for that on wild boar. I think we just reached level 4 on spotting, but on tracking I'm not sure. Maybe level 5, 6, something like that. Don't know. So we already got 4 female wild boars. And not even one male. Okay, here you can see it, age 29 to 54 minutes. I think that's not very accurate. It doesn't help a lot at all, actually. By the way, I'm not sure if we can check out on my profile now if I reached the 1000 hours yet, because maybe it only will refresh when ended the session. Yeah. So, since it was 2 hours something, I think we should have reached it almost. Oh, there's another one. Now, come on, please. One male. It looks good. That's a male. Yes. Let's try to call it then. I want the caller this time. So I even could set up the ground blind, but it's a bit too risky, I guess. Let's hope he's gonna turn towards us. Finally, a male. That was about time. Let's see if he's reacting. Should I take a longer shot here, or I don't know. I think I like to wait a little bit. Because possibly there is even more than only this one. But again, doesn't look like he's really reacting. Overcalling is not an option here. Lucas asks if I think that an electronic call that you place down and then control it would be cool. I don't know, since I'm European, and here that sort of hunting is not allowed, and I actually have no attachment to that kind of hunting, so I personally would not really, I would not really like that. I mean, I would not, I don't know, I can imagine that it would make the game a little bit too easy. Like the calling part of it. But then again, it's also not too much different from the sense. And it most likely would be annoying, the sound constantly. I don't know. Royal Official asks if I have ever been killed by an animal. Yes, I did. I have. by a wild. Oh, there is that female. It could actually happen right now if I don't watch out. Now I have to watch out. I think I'm gonna take him before the other one is going to spook him. Yeah, looks like he went down. Nope. Whoa. I think the first and the last shot could have hit. I mean, the first one I'm pretty sure hit him. Sorry that I had to do that so fast now. Oh, there is actually... What is that? Was there a third one? Ah, that was a miss probably. Well, that was some crazy shooting now. Let's see. That at least was a hard and long shot. So we should find that one pretty fast. Then we will take care about the situation down there. That map is Hirschfelden. Okay, here we go already. Right lung, 132.822. What a small female. And now let's see. About the other two wild boars. Find a blood trail now. That would be ideal. Oh, there. So far there is no blood, but I'm quite sure that the first shot was a hit. Yeah, here we go, intestine. Okay, so we reached level 7 in wild boar tracking. And it looks like... let's just see if we actually had two different animals that we took a shot. I think the last shot that I took was not a hit. Quite sure about that. And I think there is the first animal down. Yeah, that should be the male one. Excuse me. There's lots of tracks. So let's see, what do we have here? Oh, that looks, yeah, average. So we had two hits on that one. First intestines, second body shot. And a score of 536.418 T. And now let's see the result. Position 84. So we did not improve that much. But at least a male animal for the score. Now let's see if there was another blood track. That's definitely not blood. Let's just look around a little bit to be sure we don't leave a wounded animal here. Yeah, let's check out that as well. Yeah, looks good. Looks like we do not leave any wounded animals left, like suffering. Yeah, that's also only droppings. Okay, that looks good. So yeah, I think we pretty much covered it all. And I also believe that we should cover the 1,000 hours of of playing on my account. And yes, I am very excited about the Red Fox. I just hope that the developers will not take too much over from the Coyote, because I believe that a fox does not have anything in common with a Coyote. And when the developers mentioned that they are working on the fox, they said that they would have actually parts to work with from other animals, and I'm very sure they meant the Coyote, but I hope that shape and also animations will be completely different for the fox than for the Coyote, because I don't think they have anything in common, despite roughly the size, you know. So okay, but for this hunt, I think we can call it a day. I will end the hunt here, and we can look at the stats together, and also check out if the 1,000 hours on my account have been reached. I hope so. If not, we can discuss if we should go back, or maybe let's just. Let's do to be sure. Yeah, let's like 10 minutes or something more in game here. And the developers also mentioned that the fox will be a big population on Hjemmeldal and a very small one on Hirschfelden. And I hope that the population on Hirschfelden won't be too small, because the fox is quite common in Germany, and I know that a lot of German hunters would be very disappointed to have the fox only, you know, very elusive here in Hirschfelden. I personally would not mind that much, you know, but you know, I think that Hirschfelden is Hjemmeldal is going to be awesome for the fox. You know, bright red fox will look fantastic on the snow. And there is actually my tripod that I left there. So we could actually go on it and see if we can spot something from there. I think there's a pheasant, and well, I could, and there's a roe deer female. I think if I manage to shoot that one with the bow, then we covered a male specimen from each species available on Hirschfelden in this hunt. Which actually would be kind of cool. Lucas asks if the fox will come out with a new map or just be put in reserves that are existing. The developers said that the fox will be on Hjemmeldal and Hirschfelden, so there is no reserve planned, and I also can understand that pretty much, because as they have stated, the developers, they are working their butts off for multiplayer, so there probably is no time for a additional map. Oh, there is a, there's that, there's actually two of them. He's at 30. That one looks, does it look bigger? I think yes. Also at 30 meters. I think I'm going for this one. Got him. Maybe the other one too. Oh no, he just moved. Dang. But I think we got the bigger one. And with this we actually covered all species and even a male specimen from each. Which is kind of cool. .8 ground, of course. Whoop. Oh, we got him in the neck. Nice. So I think this actually was quite a good hunting session. We might even be a few minutes off the 1,000 hours still, but see. It's interesting. Sometimes there's a lot of animals in one area, and sometimes you travel for ages not seeing one single one. I think that's down to roaming patterns. Just by the way, the developers mentioned on the status update that the servers might be down for a long time tomorrow, because obviously moving all the players into the, you know, into the multiplayer, or like, you know, transferring all that data, that new stuff, that of course might take a lot of time. So yeah, I think tomorrow there will be a long time of downtime, and oh yes, Ononemi just reminded me to not forget to mention that the developers are working you know, during the whole weekend in order to make it happen for us on Monday. So I think that's just awesome. And especially having a team that small working on a game like this, I think they do a brilliant job. All right, a female is reacting on the call. It's a bit hard to spot it. I think we will see it soon enough. But yes, I, you know, I can't wait for multiplayer. It's gonna be so awesome. I've been waiting 4 years now, since ever this game has been, you know, started. Actually, since that, people have been asking for a multiplayer mode, just because, I mean, what better could it be than hunting with your friends together? I think a lot of people do that in real life, and they also, you know, when they talk about it, they say that's actually the best part of hunting, to be able to be with your friends in the woods, in nature, and, you know, just sharing time and hunting together. So I'm really looking forward to that. So I think we try to get this female here with the bow, and after that we call it a day for this live stream. And time after time, I'm, you know, it's overwhelming to see you guys watching, like, you know, to see that it's like 20 plus people watching my live stream. That's really, really cheering me up and making me want to continue that. So thanks a lot for that. Okay, that should be a long shot. Yeah. It's down. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for being with me here on that hunt. And who knows, we might meet up in game the next time. You never know. Yeah, left lung. So I think there is no need to take a picture of that one. And yeah, with that one, I'm gonna end this session here, and we will just check out the stats and also if we covered the 1,000 hours. If not, it's no biggie. Then we are at least very close. So let me put this. Let's look at the statistics first. We had a few misses. So 83.3% on the bow. 66.7 even on the unshits. We spotted 12 animals overall, and we tracked 9 of them, and we harvested 9 of them. And that is what we shot in this section, in this one. The session before we shot 2 red stags, so that adds to it, and we shot that roe deer buck. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 female wild boars and 1 male, and that pheasant and that roe deer female as well. And now let's look at the lifetime stats. And yes, we got it. We are even we're even half an hour over 1,000 hours. So that's a really cool thing to experience that life together with you guys, 1,000 hours. That's quite a milestone. So I can say now I've played 1,000 hours of single player, so bring on the next 1,000 hours in multiplayer. I think that's just that fits well. And what else? I think I wanted to do something else, to show you something else here. Oh yeah, I wanted to look at that status update together with you guys. Here we go. Multiplayer release date. We are aiming to release multiplayer this coming Monday, 3rd June. So make sure you play a lot during the weekend, since the site and game will be down for a long time on Monday while we are updating. And remember to get a membership. Happy hunting. So I'm really, really looking forward to multiplayer, and Looking forward to produce videos for you guys, and I can promise you it's going to be more videos again soon. You know, just the last couple weeks before multiplayer, I pretty much yeah, I was just waiting for multiplayer all the time and couldn't be asked to play so much single player. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to that, and as always, thank you for watching, and happy hunting to you.